Big Show.
The Big Show.
Put your hands together for the one and only
Glenn, Angel, FD, and Sean.
That's what I'm talking about.
1FM 91.33. Good times, greatest hits.
Good morning and welcome to The Big Show. It's Glenn, Angel, FD, and Sean. Thank you so much for having us on. You know, we hope you've been enjoying the show, and we know that you're going to be enjoying the next half an hour or so, because we have yet another legend with us on The Big Show and The Big Show TV. The one, the only...
Laura Tenderheart.
Lauretta Alabons, everybody.
Nice to see you. Thank you for having me. Glenn, thank you for, you know, arranging this.
No worries, man. Our pleasure.
Good morning, Lauretta. It has been quite a number of years since we've seen you, and you're still looking as amazing as ever. What have you been up to all these years?
You know what? It's funny you say that, because some people thought I'm overseas. I left Singapore. I've been so behind the scenes. I've been so behind the scenes. I've been so, believe it or not, I've been so busy, you know, with my business. You know, we set up, I set up LAMC Productions, a passion project, just didn't have a plan and no plan at all. You know, when people say, you know, when I look at all the new startups now, all the tech startups, oh, they have a business plan, they have this, you know, Series A funding, they have the venture capital, blah, blah, blah. You know, guess what? I didn't have that. I just started it with my own money. But, you know, 20 years after, I'm going to learn how to raise capital. Can you believe it, Mark, Sean, and Glenn? I'm just learning this journey now on how to raise capital and how to value my business.
Nice. It's never too late.
This has been 20 years.
Yeah. So I started the music. I can't believe the time has gone like that.
Oh, you know, I just want to let everyone in on Loretta's career little bit.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So years ago, Lauretta was a radio presenter on 91.3.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. And this was what, more than 20 years ago? This was like 25 years ago.
We don't need it.
And that's the reason why, you know, Angel mentioned Tenderheart earlier on, because every DJ had a moniker at that time. And Lauretta was Lauretta Tenderheart Alabons.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. And after that, of course, Lauretta went on to become a TV personality as well.
That's true.
And of course, we remember Lauretta on Rolling Good Times.
Yes.
Right? And right after that, you know, you set up your company, LAMC Productions.
I did Showbuzz, actually.
Showbuzz. Yes.
Yeah, that's right. So Rolling Good Times and Showbuzz. Did you do any acting as well? No, right?
No, but here's the thing. I don't know whether you guys remember. I remember my relationship with Lauretta goes back much, much further than that.
Yes.
To when she was very young, she used to be one of my DJs.
Oh, really? Wow. Well, must have been one of the very few female DJs.
One of my DJs.
Do you remember East West Express?
Yes. Yeah, I'll tell you something. Mark, I had such a crush on you.
Oh! What? Oh my God!
So mean!
No,
I had such a crush on you. You know, I used to come back home from school and listen to Ready Fusion, and I used to tape your voice.
Oh no!
He's going pink!
Oh my God. Of all the guys at that time, you had to pick the one with the long ponytail.
Oh my goodness. Oh wow.
And she's looking at you now and going, I still love your hair, Mark.
Oh my goodness. You know, it's Ross listening in right now.
It's fine. Harmless.
It's harmless.
Speaking of family, I think you know, everyone will want to know as well. So Lauretta is married to Ross. Mm-hmm. You know, we love Ross. And you have a son.
Who's an adult now,
yes.
isn't he?
How old is he?
He's going to be 21 this year.
Wow. How amazing is that?
Incredible.
And you know what? He's quite good looking, but he's so unassuming and he's so modest about it.
Oh my.
So when you see someone like him walking on the street, like I don't even think that he's my son. He doesn't look like me. He okay. doesn't look like the father too.
Oh wow.
I mean, it's just so a different mix, you know, it's such yeah. a mix. It's so mixed, so
and I can tell he's so cool, you know, he's like he's a rocker, isn't he?
He's a cool cat.
You know what he was listening to the other day? He was listening to A Flock of Seagulls, Iran.
Oh, no way.
You wow, just played yeah. that last week. Oh, my yeah. goodness.
Your son has good taste in music.
Thank you, Mark.
That's incredible. Okay, we're going to go on to The Big Show TV and carry on our conversation with Lauretta Alabons of LAMC Productions.
All right, here's Belinda Carlisle. Leave a Light on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. Good morning. Okay, so, you know, let's get down to business
yes.
because
yes.
I think there's something very exciting that Lauretta wants to tell us about that is happening, I think, next month. Huh?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so tell us, you're collaborating with Kumar on this project. Tell us more, Lauretta.
So this is a project that has been, it's very close to my heart. It's, and, you know, I don't like the word minorities. I just don't like the word minorities, but I said to myself, you know, like, you know, with all this, you know, there's an increase. I've noticed an increase of racism now, you know. I mean, it's been going on. It's not new, but I think the COVID has kind of escalated it. Hmm. And I really looked deep into myself and I said, what can I do? What should I do to help the nation address the situation and also help the government? Because I see, you know, our law minister, Shamugam, you know, advocating, you know, this all the time. And I said, why don't I use my platform? Why don't I use my voice and come forward rather than, you know, keeping quiet, sweeping things under the carpet? So, you know, we've been having a good working relationship with Kumar these past few months. And I said to Kumar, you know, this has been kind of, you know, bothering me, and I want to, you know, see whether we can be a voice for all the couples, marriages who are in an interracial relationship. And I said, why don't we do a show to let these couples come forward and tell and share their stories of strength? You know, we cannot change the world, we know that, but, you know, hopefully we can start a conversation going, and we can let couples come and share their stories, their trials, their successes, how they coped, you know, so these couples can be an inspiration to younger generations.
Okay.
Really,
so just to understand, it's not a typical Kumar stand-up comedy show or an act. It is more like a talk show setting.
So Angel, that's a good question. We know this is a tough and heavy subject. I think anything to do with race is heavy. Mm-hmm. And how we developed it with Kumar, we said, Kumar, why don't you start the show? You start the show with some comedy. So we set the context straight. So once, you know, you set the context straight, then people, you know, kind of get an idea that, okay, so this is it's meant to be lighthearted. It's not meant to be a serious conversation.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of these couples will be joking. It's very lighthearted,
yeah.
but there's a lot of serious messages in what they're saying.
Yeah,
because they're really revealing things that you don't normally discuss, and everything's really like kept inside your heart. So when we were interviewing these couples on Zoom, and when they came to the office, they basically told us, and thank you so much for doing this, because we've always wanted to share our stories, but didn't know how to do it and where to do it.
Okay.
That's going to be interesting, because it's interesting that you're taking the lighter side of it, because from what we've seen, particularly on social media, it is very, I mean, I don't mean to put it this way, but it seems almost angry.
Of course.
It's malicious.
There's a lot of anger.
Of course. People have been bottling everything inside for many years. You know, I hear Kumar is a message for 1FM fans, huh? Loretta, right?
Yes. He did it especially for y'all.
Oh, okay. Fantastic. Okay.
All right, let's roll, Sean.
Hello, Singapore, and all the listeners of OneFM. I'm doing a brand new show about interracial marriages where I talk to mixed race couples about their ups and downs. Is Singapore a racist country? Come and find out and be your own judge. This will be on video on demand on the September the 4th. Cystic Live.
He says video on demand.
Yeah, what is that? What does that mean?
How can people be a part of this?
So we recorded it. We're going to pre-record the show. And then, you know, we will do, we'll ask the viewers to basically send us messages. So they want to chat with us for future episodes. They can email us. They can IG story us. They can, you know, yeah.
So you said future episodes. So you're planning to make this a series?
Yes, Angel. So for this first episode, it's all Singaporeans, Malaysians. You know, it's basically going to be your Chinese lady marrying an Indian man. Then you have your Malay person marrying a Eurasian person.
Right.
So it's just very. We kept it very Singapore. You know, local first.
Right.
Mm. And then we will go to the next stage. You know, we'll interview the children. We, of course, want to talk about, you know, the locals with the expats, you know.
So will it always revolve around the same topic of interracial relationships, or will it evolve into other topics?
Well, we're going to, we plan for six episodes, but I think it can go on because there's a lot of stories to hear. And it's all about story, you know, storytelling. And so we just want to, you know, hear people's stories.
I love that.
There's so many people who are in interracial relationships. I mean, just look at all of us here.
Yeah. We're all, every single one of us.
We are the product of interracial relationships. FD is in an interracial relationship
right now.
So is Angel. So am I.
Yeah.
You know, Sean is in multiple interracial relationships.
Yeah. And from one as well.
Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, Singapore, not only did we grow up in an interracial community, you know, a multiracial community, I must say, but we've had friends from all races. The thing I don't understand now is it because of social media that we're seeing more of this now?
I think so.
Or has it always been there?
I think it's a combination of not only social media, but the fact that we're locked down in a very small island with nowhere to go.
But we've grown up with neighbors that are from all different races.
You see, Loretta, they're fighting already.
We're not fighting. We're having a conversation.
This is what I had a conversation with the boss last night about. It's like, why the hell are these guys fighting half the time when oh, I have to tell you all about this. You see what I mean?
Nonsense.
So Loretta is now the moderator now, just watching the both of you. No?
No, Loretta, I am very interested because I understand from social media a lot of what's happening now is local. But it's interesting that you're going to take it into the expat market too, because I think that's something a lot of Singaporeans don't comprehend. The interracial problems that the expats have here.
20 seconds.
Okay, hold on, Loretta. We're going to go back on air. And you know, let's touch on this show again. Yeah. So this will be exclusively for the radio listeners. What we just did was for the people who are watching us on Facebook, okay? So we'll ask you a little bit more about the show. Yeah.
Stand by.
Ellie Goulding right here on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3, a wonderful track called Love Me Like I Do. Our special guest for this morning is Lauretta Alabons, founder of LAMC Productions, former radio presenter on 91.3, former TV personality for hosting shows like Rolling Good Times with Douglas Olivero and Showbuzz as well. I remember, I think your co-host was Lawrence Chow, right?
Yes.
You see?
Lawrence, how many of you remember
Lawrence Chow? By the way, have you caught up with Lawrence in any way? Any idea what he's up to these days?
He's in Canada.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
So the great thing about COVID is you're reaching out to a lot of people. I'm just connecting with everyone. It's so great. I met Eric Koo last year.
Yeah.
You know, it's meeting with you guys, you know, and seeing, I mean, I want to say all of you look so fabulous.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Not as fabulous as you, Loretta.
Man, you look so handsome. You look so young.
Oh, no.
I follow you, Sean, all the time. I see you exercising. I'm so inspired.
Thank you. Heart.
You look so handsome. I love your hair.
Thank you.
You look so great. All of y'all, such good, the best looking radio personalities in the whole of Asia.
Whoa. Wow.
Thanks, Loretta. Thank I would like you. To take all the credit, but I have to give some of the credit to my Dr. Waffles Wu.
And that's why we do radio.
Faces for radio.
Yeah.
Okay, Loretta, so you've got this very exciting project that you want to tell all our radio listeners about, and you're collaborating with the one and only Kumar.
Yes.
Tell us more.
So we're going to have the show all about interracial marriages, and it's just to basically we're heeding our Prime Minister's message, his National Day message. It's a very strong message. I'm just going to mention it here. I think we put it in our press release, and he says, our Prime Minister says, we must not lightly give up this hard-won and delicate balance. As our society evolves, we have to continually adjust the balance to maintain our social harmony. So it's the government's, he says it's the government's duty to manage these issues on behalf of all Singaporeans, regardless of race, language, or religion. But I feel, as a Singaporean, I feel it's also our responsibility to, you know, contribute and, you know, make Singapore a better place to live in. And I think every race should just understand and accept each other. It's not about the race, it's about the person. So I never see, you know, like a, I never see the color in a person. I just see the person for the person. Does it make sense?
Yes. Absolutely. Yeah.
Absolutely. I don't even understand why we have all these issues happening, because as I mentioned just now on the Big Show TV, we are all products of interracial marriages. We have friends of all races, right? And we get along with them, you know, so nicely.
Yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
And we are in interracial marriages as well right now.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So. Yeah. So I don't understand where all this angst is coming from.
Well, I like what Loretta said, that you don't see color, you only see people for who they are, which was the way I was brought up as well. It was never about, oh, who's your friend? Is he Chinese or Indian?
Exactly.
You know, it was more like, tell me more about your friend. You know, and it's just that it's just a person as a person.
Well, it's interesting because I did a social media show with some people regarding racial harmony.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, I said, I look at myself as Singaporean first, Eurasian second.
Hmm.
And the comment that came back was, oh, wow, what a great thing. And to me, it's always been natural. I'm a Singaporean.
Yeah.
You know, it's not that I'm Eurasian, Chinese, Malay, Indian or whatever. I'm a Singaporean.
Yeah.
So
and
I think
people don't see that.
Yeah. This is a great show that everyone can look forward to. Loretta, thanks so much for doing this. This is LAMC Productions presents Let's Tango. And this is where Kumar will talk heart to heart with interracial couples. It sounds very, very exciting. It's happening on the 4th of September and tickets are available via Systic.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, Angel. And you can grab them now. I mean, so it's going to be very well produced. It's almost going to be like a TV show.
Okay. So,
oh, wow. That's amazing.
It's we put a lot of effort. I mean, every night we're having meetings with the couples. We've hired a producer. We've hired a writer. So it's going to be so, you know, almost like a TV show. Mm. And we hope to sell it to a TV network.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
I think this will
be. Hey, you know, why not everyone just follow LAMC on Instagram?
Yes.
It's called LAMC Productions.
All the details are there.
Yep.
All right. We continue to talk to Lauretta Alabons on the Big Show TV while we take a listen to Enigma right now. Here's Return to Innocence on the Big Show, 1FM 91.3.
So once again, that's LAMC Productions on Instagram, and their link in bio will lead you straight to buying those tickets for Systic.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I just want to say this as well, you know, Loretta. I mean, FD and myself, we've been here at 1FM for the past 6 years or so, and we've worked with you guys on so many occasions. What a pleasure.
You're the best.
All these years. You're the best.
Miss you guys, you know.
We should catch up, definitely.
Yeah.
So what's happened with you with this COVID situation? The concerts are not happening. Mm. How have you pivoted your business?
Is this live now?
We're on Big Show TV. Yeah,
TV,
on Facebook.
So what we've been doing is we can book all these acts, you know, virtually now.
Mm.
So it's not just the music. The comedy is a bit tough. because comedians don't want to, you know, not all the comedians want to do virtual shows, yeah, but right. we can, we're doing mental health speakers, which is really amazing, you know. And Mark, you hosted Elon Musk's mother.
I know, when I interviewed, yeah. I totally fell in love with her. She's such an amazing woman.
Yeah, so, you know, with virtual, like, they don't have to come here. You just see them face to face. So we've pivoted to doing a lot of virtual shows. Mm. But people, I guess, want the live shows. I guess they're still hungry for that live entertainment.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
I think it's the in-person human connection that people are missing as well, that you can still get the entertainment value, I feel, from virtual, but not that connection that the performer can have with the audience.
But it's interesting that you've got such a positive slant on it, because a lot of people are seeing this whole COVID and the lockdown and everything as being so negative, but you found a way to find the positive in it.
You know, Mark, when we were going right into the COVID last year, I basically, again, I always ask deep into myself, what am I going to do? You know, like, and then I just said, why don't I just do this podcast? I didn't know how to do it. I didn't know, I'd be really honest, I didn't know how to do it, but I just said, let's try. And then I just set up the whole system at home. It's nothing fancy. It's just the same thing and with a mic. And then I started interviewing all these celebrities.
Right.
And everybody just said, oh my God. And they started thanking me. So I connected with Papa Roach.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
311, you know 311, the
yes,
band?
Yes, yes.
So down. I hooked up with Nick Hixum. He was so lovely. He gave me, they gave me their time. And the reason why they gave me their time is because we're legit. Yeah. Legit company that wants to reach out to these bands that they never had, they never came to Singapore, never had, much radio airplay as well, because, we don't play their music, right?
Right.
So it was exciting. How much can we talk about that? Oh, we go on.
Please go on.
Are you finding me interesting?
Absolutely.
Of course.
And are you still doing this podcast, Lauretta?
I would like to do it. In fact, I came across this phenomenal singer, Jimmy Webb. So he just celebrated his birthday a few days ago. Mm. And I was thinking about doing a podcast on songs. So Jimmy Webb wrote, MacArthur Park. He wrote Wichita Lineman and Galveston and all these great songs. So I just wanted to find out the ideas behind the songs. Because, a lot of these artists, they're not going to be around any much longer.
Mm. Yeah.
So, I do want to figure out, the inspirations behind those beautiful songs they wrote. I really love my business. I really love I really love all these artists and the work they create, and I get so emotional when I read about them.
Just one question, Lauretta. You said you went into LAMC 20 years ago as a passion project.
Yes.
Why did you decide to start it, and what did you think it was going to become?
Again, Angel, I didn't have any plan.
Hmm.
I just had a premonition. And with all founders, with all business owners, they always say you have to go with your intuition. And funny that you say that, because of late, I've been reading this book by Napoleon Hill. And Napoleon Hill, he has got this phenomenal book. I think it was written in 1937. And he, even way back then, he talks about how important it is for business owners to have intuition and to listen to your inner voice. So when people tell me, don't listen to your inner voice, I don't know what they're talking about. Because, Andrew Carnegie and all these great people, what they did was listen to their inner voice. Mm. And that's what I do every day. And I advise everyone to just listen to their inner voice, because that inner voice gives you that step and courage to move forward.
Yeah.
You just listen to yourself. And I guess if you really want to know that if you're doing the right thing, it's just maybe spend 2 or 3 minutes a day just closing your eyes and doing some meditation.
Yeah.
And then you will get the courage
And the clarity.
I'm a bit afraid of this inner voice because, you know, the inner voice is always telling me to punch people. Loretta, I have to hold back. I have to, you know, like inner voice, don't say so much.
You need
please.
To pull out that other inner voice.
I think there's, yeah,
there's another one. There's another one in there somewhere.
The one that went to church before.
Yeah.
Not this one.
Right. These days, you know, it's like, you know, there's so many people, like, I want to punch.
Yeah, so
for some reason.
He's got a very violent inner voice.
So it's good that the outer voice is the voice of reason then.
Yeah, you just got to smile all the time.
You know what? I like it when you say that, because that takes courage to say that.
Just, you know, just being, hey, are we live on
Facebook?
So there are a lot of things I say when we are on Facebook Live, but then when I, you know, go back on radio, then I'll say something else.
Yeah. The nicer one.
We can be a bit braver on Facebook Live. Yeah.
Yes. Do you want to name the names of the people you want to punch?
No, let's not go there, please.
Please don't say that. But I think, you know what, speaking of, you know, punching people and all that, I think during these times, okay, I mean, during this extraordinary time, there are many people who are angry. You know, they're angry because their lives have changed so very much. They have less to look forward to. Mm. You know, the little breaks that they take, you know, when they clear their leave, you know, from the stress or stresses at work, they can't do that anymore. They're forced to take staycations, you know, within, you know, their various countries. I mean, not just Singaporeans, but people from around the world. And so everyone is getting so agitated.
Yeah.
You know, they're on edge all the time.
And staycations are not like vacations. You're still here.
Different.
So people feel like they can still reach out to you. I don't know if you feel this as well, Loretta, that even if you take a staycation or you take a couple of days off, it's still work for you. Very different from getting on an airplane and actually going to the beach and getting some downtime. Do you feel that? Or are you the workaholic that works 24/7?
I have to say I work 24/7.
Okay.
Because I just love what I do and it's not even work.
Hmm.
It's not even work. I mean, I get up in the morning with so much excitement.
Mm. Oh, that's fantastic.
I get up like, what can I, you know, I have so much energy, you know, the business has brought me so much. It's hard to explain. Mm-hmm.
It's amazing that Loretta has expressed herself this way, because I mean I speak for all of us here, you know, on the show, you know. Yeah, I mean, we wake up every morning and we love it.
We love it as well.
Right?
Yeah.
But I have to say, all the other breakfast show, they have to drag themselves out of bed, you know. They just do it.
Okay, talk about them on air.
OneFM 91.3 traffic.
Tampines Avenue 5 near the junction of Avenue 2. We've got an accident there. AYE towards Tuas. An accident after Clementi Road exit. Avoid lane 5. Excuse me. AYE towards Tuas. Another accident after Lower Delta Road exit. PIE towards Tuas. An accident after Stevens Road exit. Avoid lane 1. Please stay within the speed limit. Have everyone buckled up. Be safe as you drive today.
Good morning, Singapore. Good morning, world. Welcome to The Big Show and The Big Show TV. Our guest for this morning is the legend, Loretta Alabons. Good morning, Loretta.
Good morning, Glenn. Good morning, Mark. Good morning, morning. Sean. Good morning, beautiful angel.
Good morning, Loretta.
Loretta, you know, Glenn was talking about how uptight people are in Singapore, but I've been listening to you through this.
Hey, don't just say that and people will hate me here in Singapore.
No, they don't like you very much.
I see it all the time.
But that wasn't the context. You cannot just say Glenn says Singaporeans are uptight. You kill me.
He mentioned wanting to hit some people.
I'm just saying. Oh my God. I'm just, Loretta, look at what these people are doing.
No, but here's the thing.
Okay.
No. Wait. Let's just clarify. I did not say Singaporeans are uptight people. Loretta, did I say Singaporeans are uptight people? I didn't say they're just like that. No, that's not true.
I think what you're saying, Glenn, is people feel...
uptight.
escalated.
Escalated the uptightness.
Let me clarify.
Okay, so I said
Singaporeans are on edge. Yeah. So are people from other countries because of these extraordinary times, because of COVID-19. Yes. You know, we're all cooped up in our own homes and in our own countries. That's the reason why. Okay, that's better.
Okay.
You cannot just say Glenn says Singaporeans are uptight people.
So here's the point I wanted to make. I've been listening to you through this interview. You've admitted you're a workaholic. You get up at like 3 o'clock in the morning to start your work. You work 24/7, but you are so calm.
Mm.
How do you do that?
You don't look stressed at all.
Yeah, still looking so beautiful.
That's good.
How do you do that?
I don't know. I really don't know. I think I love what I do so much. So the love, I guess...
Overflow.
Basically, we're asking you, how come you look like you and FD looks like him?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, because
come on,
he's also a workaholic. You know, FD is also a workaholic. He's working all the time. We can see that he's a workaholic.
And I look like
but we can't tell that you are like that. You know,
that's good.
Yeah, that is.
Yeah,
good.
It's very good for you.
And Loretta wakes up at 3 a.m. in the morning.
I know. That's crazy.
Doesn't go back to sleep.
It's no alarm clock. I just get up myself.
Wow. Amazing, Loretta. I know you say you love your work. You're very passionate about what you do, but I'm sure that you do something outside of work that you also love. What do you do for fun? Don't say work, please.
You know, I love. Okay, I love. Of course, I love listening to your morning show.
Thank you.
You all do a great job. I love watching Netflix. Mm-hmm. And just a few days ago, I had such a joy. I was on a variety Zoom room with Michael Douglas, Morgan Freeman, Paul Reiser, because you know their show is nominated for an Emmy Awards.
Mm.
I love Netflix.
Wow, that's
so
amazing.
Netflix is your way out.
I love watching CNN. I watch CNN. I watch CNBC. So, you know what I do, and a little bit of exercise. I'm not an exercise freak.
It's okay. So we'll get there.
I watch Sean.
You watch Sean.
Sean is
exercise
entertaining.
For you.
You see, just now we interrupted Loretta. She said Sean. It's not like pawn.
Yeah, I know. That's what I thought she said. I was like, what?
I panicked. Yeah.
Sean, what kind of videos are you recording now?
All kinds.
These are the secret ones, aren't they?
Yeah, I sent to you.
No, please don't.
But, you know, I mean, Loretta is spot on, you know, and I've always believed, like, you know, some people, they're connecting with the masses, what the masses want, you know, just like a radio presenter needs to connect as well, you know, in order to be successful. So you mentioned Netflix. We all love Netflix as well.
Yeah.
You know, you ask me to watch Free to Air, I feel like vomiting. You know, Netflix is in. And then what else were you mentioning just now?
CNN.
CNBC.
Yeah,
Sean.
These are the news channels that we watch as well.
That is true. We do
Sean,
have CNN
what
on
say?
Now. Sean, no, she,
oh,
watches,
she watches
Sean.
Oh, yeah.
Sean, yeah.
What do you watch, Sean, actually? His Instagram, is it?
Yes.
But you know, Loretta, we have this question from Benedict Tan, who's watching us on Facebook, and he's got the same, he's watching you, and he's coming up with the same sort of questions I'm coming up with.
Okay.
You love your job, you wake up, you get excited about doing it, but how do you draw the line between work and life? Where does the line come in?
That's a good question.
How do you do it?
I don't know, Mark.
Forget the line now. Why do we need the line?
Blurred lines.
Yeah.
You don't need the line.
You don't need a line. I guess if you love your job well enough, you don't need the line.
Yeah, and you don't mind talking about it outside of work or before you go to sleep or anything.
I don't talk to anybody about work.
Okay.
Nobody will understand what I'm doing. And I don't want to come across like, you know, being a show-off. So I've always kept, you know, I don't know whether you know, I've always kept a low profile. You know, I don't normally tell people what I'm doing, you know. So a lot of people, I mean, be honest, Glenn, I want to be honest here. People don't know I have that I started LA Comedy Live. So people don't know I created, you know, the comedy business. I started it in Asia.
Right.
But nobody knows this because, you know, they just see LAMC Productions. But, and truth be told, you know, I mean, I've been, you know, busy also working behind the scenes, and I really like it. I really enjoy it. you know, bringing all the great comedians to Singapore, Hong Kong, and throughout Asia.
That's fantastic.
We have been basically promoting racial harmony through our music and comedy shows, because we would never focus on bringing an act that just appeals to one race.
Mm. Mm.
That was never what we set out to do for the business, because the business has always been meant to connect people from all over the world. For instance, a Metallica show could bring out 130 different races.
Mm.
And there's no, you know, nobody says, oh, you know, you're Chinese, you're Malay, you're this, you're that. Everybody comes together and enjoys the shows together.
Right.
So that's what we've been, both Ross and myself, this was our motto from day one. Our business, you know, we were never going to be, you know, instilling any racism. We love everybody. We love all the races. We call them our brothers and sisters. We love our brothers and sisters. So, you know, and we love to see everyone, every race, you know, whether you're black, white, whatever. It's not even a color.
It is a human race, isn't it?
Yeah. And you know, Angel, I started promoting Indian comedians, like from India, because I was, you know, so we brought a lot of the very big Indian comedians from India, and I'm proud to be associated with them.
Mm.
And I'm proud to, you know, bring on a comedian from Persia. So we've done so much, you know, things with, you know, supporting diversity. Mm. Gays and lesbians, and you know, we're all part of that family, because they're all one. It's not about, you know.
And that's why you love this radio station, because it's one FM.
Yeah. That's fantastic. We're speaking to Lauretta Alabons of LAMC Productions, and their latest production is Let's Tango. It's on the 4th of September. It's online. You can get your tickets via cystic.com. And it features Kumar talking heart-to-heart with interracial couples. Tickets are on sale now for $30 only. So go to cystic.com and search Let's Tango, or go to LAMC Productions and just click on the link in their bio.
Yeah, we'll continue to talk to Lauretta for a while longer, while more on The Big Show TV. But for the benefit of the fans who are tuned in exclusively on the radio right now, thank you so much, Lauretta, for joining us today.
You know what? I've just remembered someone. Maybe his soul came to say hi. Jamie.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yes.
On your anniversary, right?
Right. Yes. A couple of days ago. Yeah.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Good morning, Jamie.
Good morning. Okay, up next, New Kids on the Block, Cover Girl, right here on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. Yeah, we were just remembering him the other day as well.
Yeah, last Saturday was his 1-year anniversary.
For those of you who are watching, if you're wondering who Jamie is, he was our program director here on 1FM 91.3.
That was a shock.
And he passed away last year.
Yeah, it was a shock.
And you worked with him very, very closely, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we were in tears, actually.
Mm. Yeah.
A lot of us were, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it came as a total, you know, shock to all of us as well. Yeah, because we're just like, you know, in touch with him the night before.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyways. Yeah, anything else for Lauretta?
No, I think that's busy. It. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I know she's dying to get back to those emails. She's like, oh my goodness, I need to get back to work.
Right. My desk, it's in a bad state.
Okay, but before you go, I just want to ask you, if I ask you to choose like one unforgettable act that you brought in, right, as in a band, and one forgettable act. Unforgettable comedy act. Who would they be?
I would say Guns N' Roses.
Yeah. And you worked with us on that project. It was huge.
Let's forget about TV. Let's forget about radio. I consider myself a simple person. I'm very simple. Okay? I don't like all the frills. I'm not a fan of, you know, but deep down, you know, when I say to myself, oh my God, you know, it is really once in this lifetime. The whole tour, I would never think that a girl growing up in Serangoon Gardens, going to church, you know, coming a very simple background, you know, I'm not rich, my family's not rich, you know, very simple background. I would never think myself that we could make this unbelievable thing happen.
Mm-hmm.
Every day I get up and I said, you know, I mean, I'm actually quite a timid person. I'm quite shy. I'm quite, you know, introvert. So, I get up every day and I said, I can't believe I'm doing this.
Mm.
I really can't believe. So, you know, if you dream, you can make it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that was just one band, Lauretta. The hundreds of bands.
Yeah. Absolutely.
And members that she's met.
Yeah.
You know, the
incredible.
Biggest stars. And you being, you know, so passionate about music and all that. What a dream come true.
It is.
Incredible. Well done.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And what about the comedian? Is Trevor Noah like the biggest guy that you brought in?
I love all the comedians, and I don't look at them as being, you know, big or again, I just look at them. They do a good show.
Right.
They serve a purpose. They make, you know, like for me, myself, when I buy my shows, I ask myself, do they make me happy?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So I'm not booking the shows because, you know, they're going to make the other crowd happy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm buying the shows. Are they making me happy first?
Right. Yeah.
So if they make me happy, then let everyone else be happy. But I'm doing it for myself first.
That's great. No, we need to learn from Lauretta.
That's a very interesting concept.
Yeah, because it's true. Why are we always trying to make our bosses happy?
Please everyone else. Yeah.
You know, or the radio listeners happy.
Don't know.
Right? When we are happy, they will feel the happiness.
Oh, absolutely.
True.
You know, so she's absolutely right.
Yes.
Thanks, Lauretta. From now on, we're going to change our attitude.
Okay, thank you, guys. I love you so much.
Thanks so much. Thanks, Lauretta, for your morning. Thank you.
Please send our love to Ross as well.
I will.
Okay.
Have a great week.
We'll catch up soon.
Bye.
Bye, Lauretta. Take care.
Bye.
Awesome.
Amazing.
Johan.
Jing, Johan.
Good morning.
Good morning, Johan.
Good morning, everybody.
You want to do the book review first?
Yeah, I think we do the book review. It's the second last one.
We do Johan first.
No, we do Johan first. Then we do book review on air.
Okay,
we do book review on air.
You're going on air, actually.
Sounds like a plan.
She's not listening to us.
Sounds
like
a plan. She's listening to music.
She doesn't even listen to us at all.
All right.
Only on Spotify or something.
I thought you guys were talking to Marissa
Tomei.
Whoa, who is this?
Lauretta, if you're
good
still
morning.
You don't know Lauretta Alabons?
I know.
You do, okay.
<It's> joking.
But you haven't met her, right?
No.
We should have introduced them just now.
That's true. It's okay. I'll call her back later.
It's so funny. We're getting comments on our Facebook page about the dreams that Lauretta and LAMC have made come true.
Oh, with the concerts
and
stuff.
With the band she's brought
fantastic.
In. People who thought they'd never see these bands and they got
true.
To see them.
Yeah, she's brought in so many.
You weren't around when we did Guns N' Roses. Oh my God, you know how massive that was.
No. Crazy. I wish I were.
Holy cow, it doesn't get bigger than that.
Yeah.
That was madness.
It's going to be decades before something like that happens here.
And then when I was arm wrestling Axl Rose.
You did?
What? Yeah. You remember we had like the big VIP, like whole floor just for us.
Yeah, just for
us.
Wow. So who won?
And don't forget Slash.
Axl Rose.
You know, I was playing his guitar and all that, but of course it was out of tune because I don't know how to play the guitar. So I was just jang. That's why we decided to call you Jang. That's where the jang came from.
Yes. Right.
It was an out of tune jang.
Yeah. And I tell you guys, I don't know whether you guys know it or not, but I think it was under the stage. The stage was huge, right? At Changi Exhibition Centre.
Yeah. Mm.
There was a shower built under the stage for the band members.
Yeah.
A shower.
Well, yeah, they would get like awfully sweaty up there.
They didn't use it.
Oh,
we were there.
You guys were using it, was it? Okay.
Don't tell people.
All right, what do you have for us today, Johan?
Well, since you guys brought in Lauretta.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, 2 minute.
2 minute sounds more.
2 minute.
No,
I can do a fast one.
I can do. Okay, do one. Do one.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do the Killers.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Let's do this one.
Got Coming out of my cage and I'll be doing just fine. Gotta be down because I want it all. Started out with a kiss, how it ended up like this. It was only a kiss, it was only a kiss. Now I'm falling asleep, now she's calling a cab. While she's having a smoke and she's sticking the track. Now they're going to bed and my stomach is sick. And it's all in my head, but she's touching his chest. Now he takes off her dress. Now let me go. And I just can't love, it's killing me. And taking control. Jealousy, turning seas into sea. Swimming through sick lullaby. Choking on your alibis. But it's just the price to pay. Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes. Cause I missed the bright side.
Let's
Have 30
seconds left.
Love, Mr. Brightside.
Well, after done. The book review, got one more song again, just to let you know.
Okay.
After the book review,
steady.
Huh?
Yeah, okay.
So is Anjali going to be using
yes,
your microphone? Okay.
With the
alrighty.
Okay, stand by. We come back.
Oh yeah. I can't wait. No. For this book, all the
all
books
the books
that she recommended,
so good.
I've read all of them.
Right,
oh, well done,
right,
Glenn.
Right.
Not even
reading.
Really?
You've read them all?
Yes.
Okay.
Sure.
That's great, Glenn.
Sure. Well yeah, done. You can do the reviews once actually.
Okay, stand by. Nirvana, Come As You Are, right here on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. We're also live on The Big Show TV. And it's time to bring on our returning officer.
Not today, not today.
On Friday, she's our returning officer when we do Free For All Friday. Friday, Free For All. But right now, she is our book reviewer. Every Wednesday, the one, the only, the girl whom
is going to leave us
in about 2 weeks.
Oh. This is her second last book review.
Exactly. No. Our intern extraordinaire,
yes.
Anjali.
What an introduction. Thank you so much. Okay, so today I brought with me a book that, out of all the books that I've shared on this show, I think if there's one that everyone has to read, it's this one.
That's what you say every week.
Well, today particularly so, because I think it really aligns with a lot of our interests. So this book is called Daisy Jones and the Six. It's by Taylor Jenkins Reid. That's her name. And it's basically set in the 70s.
Ooh,
and it's
nice.
About a rock and roll band
Ooh.
Called Daisy Jones and the Six.
Okay.
Okay, so this book kind of follows them from how they were just Daisy Jones and then the band The Six, how they became a band. And then it goes into like their albums, their tours, and then how they just very abruptly broke up one day in 1979. And no one knew why until this book. So that's the entire story. And what I love most is that if you open the book and you look through it, you realize that it's written in a transcript-like manner.
Okay.
So, you know, every couple sentences, you switch perspective. So it's almost as if the author sat down with an interview with every single member of the band and then pieced it all together. So not only is it very fun, but because, you know, when you have seven people in a band, there's things like musical, you know, difference of opinions and musical direction. You have feuding, you have big egos,
exactly.
People who want some things to happen and it's not happening for them. They want a bigger, you know, part in a song. All those things are happening. And because you're switching perspective, you're getting everybody's perspective on the same thing. So you're able to discern for yourself who's in the right and who's in the wrong.
Right.
Oh, wow.
I like to compare like radio shows to bands. You know?
How?
Same. Egos, feuding.
Yeah.
Sometimes just three. They can disintegrate.
Three.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's
it
also
does
gossiping
happen.
And backstabbing.
Yeah.
It's very much like radio.
It's very much like any team that works together.
Yeah. The more, the bigger the headache. The more members. So this one had what? Six, right?
Seven, actually.
Seven, oh yeah.
Seven
so
members.
Daisy plus the six.
Yeah.
Except with us. We don't feud.
No, which is why that's exactly my point. You know what I mean?
We're the best radio show, breakfast radio show.
Well, yes.
Yes.
Yes. Well, this book is also very interesting because, as you know, the 70s rock and roll scene was very, very chaotic.
Yes.
If I put it into one word, it's chaos. Mm. So that made for a very entertaining book. And the last thing I'll say is that the inspiration behind this book really got me because it's inspired by Fleetwood Mac.
Oh, one of your favorite bands.
One of my favorite bands. So the story is the author saw, the band performing, and she saw Stevie Nicks and Lindsey Buckingham. Is that his name?
Correct. Lindsey Buckingham.
So they were singing to each other, and they looked like they were in love. And she was so convinced. She was like, you can't look at each other like that and not be in love.
Yes.
You know, it was so obvious to her. Then her mother tells her, you know, they're not in love. They're not together. And that whole concept of looking like you're head over heels in love with someone and not being together inspired this book.
Oh, wow. Fantastic. Yeah. Well done. Okay, so we'll put that book up on our Facebook page, The Big Show TV. Thank you, Anjali, for our second last book review from you when you leave us so willingly. And we're going back to The Big Show TV.
Okay. And, Johan Lee is with us as well. Yes. You know, early on, he sang Mr. Brightside by The Killers. The 2 minute version. And right now, he's about to do us another song exclusively on The Big Show TV. Meantime, here's Smash Mouth with I'm a Believer on The Big Show, 1FM 91.3. Thank you so much, Anjali.
All right.
Maybe you should get Anjali to sing.
Fleetwood Mac. Anjali to sing Fleetwood Mac.
Are you a singer? Do you like to sing?
Are you a singer?
I'm not a singer.
Do you need lyrics?
What song?
Fleetwood Mac.
Oh, is it?
Oh, she's like,
he started already. The ship has sailed.
She knows.
Really? She's gonna sing?
I'm not gonna sing.
She's listening to it. But she's listening.
Oh, right. I'm not gonna sing it.
I also want to show you this, John.
Check it out.
Ooh, nice.
Wait, not finish it.
Oh.
Unadulterated fun and wit. Wait, not finish
nice
yet.
Nice one.
Hold on. There's more.
Ooh.
Wait, not finish yet.
In case you don't know who
Glenn is.
Who's that?
Glenn. Just in case we forget our names.
So, you know, everybody has one. You know, we're going to make one for you as well, Johan. I just wanted to make sure that it looked good before producing more for the people we know and love.
Yay. Thank you very much. Right. Still using your mug.
Still using the mug.
Oh, wow.
Good. It hasn't fallen apart yet. Okay, great.
Not yet.
All right, what's next?
Okay, what are we doing?
All right, let's do this one for Jamie.
Okay.
All right, something by Crowded House.
Oh.
This one's called Better Be Home Soon.
Oh.
Somewhere deep inside, something's got a hold on you. It's pushing me aside, it's stretched out forever. And I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Stripping back the coats of lies and deception, back to nothingness, like a week in the desert. And I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Don't say no, don't say nothing's wrong. Cause when you get back home, maybe I'll be gone. Cost me pain if we were to end it, but I could start again and you could be there. And I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Oh, that's why I tell you, you better be home soon.
Thank you. Nicely done. Thank you, Johan.
Thank you so much, Johan. Wow. Yeah. Our timing today is absolutely perfect.
Perfect, yes. So
cool. Well done, Sean.
Yeah.
Thank you. No
good
worries.
Stuff. Yeah, Sean. Sure,
superb.
Wrap it up.
Okay, man. Thank you so much, Johan, for joining us.
See you next week.
I love you guys.
Love you too.
You too. Bye.
Take
Bye.
Care. All right. What a great session.
It was awesome. Absolutely perfect.
Big thank you once again to Lauretta Alabons from LAMC Productions. Mm-hmm. All right. Don't forget to follow Lauretta. Lauretta and LAMC, or rather LAMC Productions on Instagram.
Mm-hmm. You can get your tickets there.
Yeah. Okay. Share the video.
Bye.
Bye-bye.